Hi, this is JP from Know the Lights Over Arkham. Welcome to another episode of Eye of Chaos, where we pick a random investigator, build a random chaos deck for that investigator, and try to do the best we can in the Midnight Mass scenario on standard difficulty. So, we have gotten some spread on the classes, but let's see what we get this time. So, last time we got the only neutral investigator in the game, Lola Hayes, but let's see if we can get something interesting this time also. So the investigator this time will be Minh Thi Phan, so a seeker, survivor. So Min is a decent solo investigator, at least when you construct the deck, so let's see if we can make some use of the chaos deck we generate for Min. So let's hop over to arkhamdb.com and build the deck. Okay, and we are over on arkhamdb.com and let's search for Min and build the deck. So here is Minh Thi Phan. So well, seekers have a good way to investigate, so I think getting clues is not a problem, but maybe running away or defeating enemies might be, but we'll see how that goes. So let's push the button and look what we get. So right away we have quite a lot of assets. So we have Cryptic Grimoire, which is useless, only good for the wild icon. Actually, we don't want to use this in any way in a standalone game. Then we have Dream Diary, same thing, not useful, so only good for the icon. We got at least one flashlight, so that's at least good. Forbidden Tome, so we are getting all of the story as tomes that are useless in standard, so not looking good. Gravedigger Shovel, and not that useful on Min. Well, maybe for defeating acolytes, but nothing more. Newspaper, not that good, because we are good at investigating either way. So the assets or the hand assets were a bit bad. But accessory slots, we have Cherished Keepsake, so that is at least good. Tooth of Estli is good. Eldritch Sophist, well, we'll have to see if there's any synergy with this card to the others. Mysterious Raven, well, it's a good way to pick up a fast high shroud level location clue. Not the best for Min, but it's okay. Witten Green, well, Witten can fetch us tomes or relics. So the tomes are useless, but maybe the relics like the Tooth of Etzli might be of some use. Then we got two copies of Hit Me, so okay. Well, we'll see. This is a newer card, so I haven't tried this in Min yet, so we'll see how this works. Anatomical diagrams. Choose a non-elite enemy on your location to the end of the episode. Well, this could be of some use, for sure, to get a better evade or something going on. Barricade is good for Min in multiplayer, but not maybe in true solo. Belly of the Beast, not good for Min because our agility is so low. Extensive research. We could have a bunch of cards in hand and play this for cheap and get two clues. So, well, can't say if it's good or bad at this point. Impromptu Barrier. Helps us evade, might be useful. Mind Over Matter, always good for seekers with low combat or agility, so this is good. Persuasion. We have humanoid enemies, so this could be good to get a humanoid enemy out of play back into the encounter deck if needed. Practice Makes Perfect. I think not a good one for a chaos deck. Seeking Answers. We could investigate at a low shroud location and grab a clue from a high shroud location, so this could be useful. seeking answers, yeah. Then we have the Truth Beckons. So this is actually good, a good card for the Midnight Mass scenario. So we usually run around and leave one location open, so this could save us a lot of movement actions if needed. Waylay. Not good because we are bad at evading. Manual Dexterity, okay. Overpower, Plan of Attack, this isn't good. And last card, True Understanding. Not a fan of this card, but okay. Let's see what the basic random weakness is. It is Hypochondria, so that is not that bad. We have plenty of sanity. Okay, well, that is the deck. Next, I will build the deck, and then let's see how Min does. So, I'll build the deck, and I'll be right back. Okay, and we are ready to begin. So, I've pre-shuffled all the decks. So, let's draw our opening hand and see how Min does in the Midnight Mask. So, not that certain we can defeat more than two or three cultists, but let's see. So double hit me, persuasion, forbidden tome, and impromptu barrier. So immediately getting rid of a lot of these cards. And I think I'm keeping these actually. These seem to be quite good. So I'm just reshuffling these two. Seeking answers and truth beckons. So okay, well, let's see what we can do with this hand. Shuffle these back into the deck. So I think our plan is to just hover clues as fast as possible, reveal some cultists and try to defeat a couple and then get out before it's too late, but we'll see how this goes. That is enough of shuffling, so let's start by just investigating. I don't want to play anything at this point. Investigating 4 versus 2. And not committing anything. We could commit and get a bonus icon, but not gonna do it at this point. 4 versus 2. It's an Elder Sign plus 1. You may choose. Well, I didn't use any skill cards, so we just get the clue. Second action, we'll move to Rivertown. Third action, we'll just investigate here. So this is a quick first turn, just get the clues and keep moving. So it's a zero, we grab this clue, and that is our turn. No enemies, we'll go to upkeep. Oh yeah, I didn't even put resources down because there's so few things I'm eager to play. So we get a card, it is impromptu barrier, and we get one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. One of six encounter card for this turn is, it is an acolyte. And it spawns at an empty location. I think we want to put it in the graveyard, persuade it, get rid of it. Yeah, so we're just putting it into the graveyard. And that is the mythos phase, so investigation phase. We'll move to the graveyard. Two clues here. And the acolyte engages us. Second action, we will persuade it. So parley, and we test intellect 3 against, and this gets plus x difficulty, where x is the horror value. Well, there is no horror value, so we're just investigating 3, and we'll commit. We could commit something. Well, no, we'll just play a hit me if we need to. So 3 versus 4 versus 3. So we're up by one. And it is minus three if you fail. Place one of your clues to your location. Oh yeah, and that sucks. Oh, no, actually. Okay, so I forgot to do this, but I'll do it right after. So we'll play the hit me. So reveal an additional chaos token, swingy. It's minus two and plus. If that is a skull token, you automatically fail. Minus one, we still fail. Well, that's a bummer. Okay, well, I'll just test it now. So, 4 versus 3 on the location. If we take the horror, minus 1, we are good. Last action, we will just try to... we'll have to try and punch this guy. So, I don't have anything to commit, so... yeah. Okay, we're taking a risk. So punching. So 2 versus 3. Minus 4. We fail. This won't save us. There is not another minus 4 in the back, so we actually needed to have a minus some 0 or something and then get a minus something to change. But yeah, we're not playing that. Okay, well, enemy phase. This guy hits us. This is not going that well yet. Oh yeah, this guy has a doom. Okay, and upkeep, we draw a card, and extensive research, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's see if we can do something meaningful on the next turn. We add another doom. Encounter card is... Obscuring Fog, so not a good location to get it, because this was an easy place to pick up those clues, but not anymore, for at least the first one. First action, we will try to evade this guy. So, committing the Truth Beacon, so I'm getting plus two to this, or the one wild icon. Minus three. I have to pick the minus 3 out on the back. So I'm playing the hit me. Minus 2, so it becomes a plus 2. So we are evading 2, 3, 4 against 5. So plus 2. So six, yeah, so we just succeed. So this guy is evaded. Then I will investigate. 4 versus 3. Minus 4. Last action will investigate. Where did... Oh yeah, I think I took the... extra clue from the token pool, not from myself, so I'm just fixing that. So investigating again, 4 versus 3, minus 1, we get rid of this, and we grab one clue. That is our turn, enemy phase, nothing upkeep, this guy readies, gets us again. We draw a card, tempt fate, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn, let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. Encounter card for this turn is another acolyte. Just place it over here. We are at 5 of 6 dooms, so we are advancing next turn if we can't get rid of one of these cultists. And first action, I think I'm committing the temp fate, so I'm getting 2. Wild icons, so I will punch for 4 against 3, so hoping to kill this acolyte off. So it's a 0, so this guy's at least defeated. Second action, we'll investigate. I'm investigating 4 versus 1. this defeated. Auto fail. Last action investigate, 4 versus 1. -2, another clue. So that is our turn. No enemy actions will go to upkeep. We draw a flashlight, we gain 1 resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Encounter card for this turn is Rip Chill. With just willpower 4 versus 4, nothing to commit. -1, we fail, so we take 2 damage because we can't discard an asset. That sucks. First action, we'll investigate. 4 versus 1. -3, we succeed. And second action, we'll reveal a cultist. We get Peter Warren. Last action, we'll reveal another cultist. And Wolfman Drew. Not the best ones for me. I was hoping to get the Gravedigger here, but it is what it is. So let's put this guy here. Peter Warren over to Miskatonic University. Enemy phase. Nothing happens. This actually is here. Upkeep. We'll draw a card. Overpower. Gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add the 6th doom, so the agenda advances. We get the Mask Hunter on us. So again, the Mask Hunter is a 4-5, 4 health plus 2 health. So 6 health and 2 evade. Humanoid Cultist Elite. Engage with the Prey, most clues, Hunter. And we can't spend or get clues while this guy's engaged with us. We need to evade it somehow and run away. We get an encounter card, and it is Hunting Shadow. We don't have any clues, so we have to take 2 damage. So we are 2 damage away from getting defeated. So this isn't looking that good. So first action, we really need to evade this guy, so I'm using the Seeking Answers to commit it to the test. So testing 4 versus 2 because we get the +1 from each ability. Skull is a -0, we don't have any cultists with Doom on them, so we pass and this guy is evaded. Second action, we'll move here. Last action, we will to south side. There's Shroud of 3, 1 clue, draw 3 cards, limit once per game. We might actually draw the cards so we can play the extensive research at the Miskatonic University to grab 2 clues. But yeah, enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep, this guy readies, draw a card. Gain 1 resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, so 1 of 8. Encounter card is Hunting Nightgown. So not what we wanted to see at this point, but it is what it is. So I think first action we just need to evade. And playing the impromptu barrier. So we get chosen enemy gets -1 to evade, so this is an automatic succeed, whatever we pull except the auto fail. So let's see. It's a 0, so this is evaded. We'll take the action to draw 3 cards. Of course, we get the Hypochondria, practice Met Perfect and True Understanding. And last action, we will investigate. I'm investigating, I'm committing I'm committing the true under. Oh yeah, we can't commit this to this test, unfortunately. Well, I'm just investigating, so 4 versus 3. Hopefully we can grab at least this clue. It's a plus 1, so we're good. So, evade. Grab cards and investigate. So that is our turn. Enemy phase, this guy wants here. Upkeep, this guy ready, engages us again. We'll draw a card. King in yellow. Okay. So you cannot commit. You cannot commit exactly one or two cards to a skill test. After a skill test is successful, it's Minh Thi Phan has committed at least 6 matching skill icons for the test. Discard King in yellow. So that is a tough one. So I think we are just committing a lot of stuff for the next investigation. Gain one resource, so that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. Encounter card for this turn is, it is a locked door, so let's just place it here. Doesn't affect, but because there's no clues on any location, so we can pick an empty location somewhere. First action, we really need to evade this guy. So I am just evading 2-1. Hopefully we can get a bit lucky here. Do we have any agility icons? No. Okay, and 0. We are able to evade this guy. Thank God. Second action, we'll move to St. Mary's Hospital. There's one clue there. And a shroud of 2, but we are investigating and committing 1, 2, 3. 4, 5. Damn, we are one short of being able to commit 6. So we are not doing that, so we're just investigating. So 4 versus 2. -3, unfortunately we fail. Enemy phase, this guy hunts here. So this is here. Upkeep, we draw a card, backpack, gain one resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom, so 3 of 8 encounter card is. So we'll get a locked door here. Well, of course we do. So unlucky. Okay, how do we want to do this? So we can't basically do anything to the locked door. We don't have enough skill icons. Or actually, can commit these 2, but nothing else. That is not enough. I'm not seeing this going that well from now on. Okay. We'll just move. Actually, we can't take the attack of opportunity. We have too much damage already. So if we move, investigate, this guy hits us. Move. Hits us again. We are dead. Stay here. This guy is moving. We are dead. So if we move, hits us in the enemy phase, we're dead. And after, we take horror, if we take damage, that doesn't matter. I hate to say this, but it seems like we are stuck here and we just need to we play this. Reduced cost. We discover, so I think we can't discover clues. We can't investigate, we can discover clues. So I'm playing the extensive research for the first action. No, it. Yeah. If we get this clue, move there, and move again, we are dead. Or if we defeat Peter Warren, we are dead. And if we do anything else, we are dead. So, yeah. First action, draw a card. Manual dexterity. Second action, draw a card. Barricade. Won't help because this is elite. Yeah. Last action, resign. Yeah, so this was a horrible run. Unfortunately, I had a bit more hope for Min doing a bit better to get at least one or two cultists, but it wasn't meant to be. So we got one victory point from the graveyard, and that is it. So yeah, Min really didn't do that well. And of course, now that I look, could have played the Eldritch Sophist, but yeah, that would have brought us one turn, but a bit too late to notice that. So okay, well, this is Eye of Chaos for you. Sometimes the deck just doesn't work at all and we get pummeled, and this was the case this time. But anyways, hope you guys like this playthrough. Thanks for watching, and until next time.